What's up, everybody? Rob Ferretti here, and I've had my first major mechanical failure of the year. You're used to having cars that are effectively getting whacked up and everything like that, but like this car here, it gets fixed. Not really a big deal. It's usually a pretty quick turnaround. It does create a little bit of turmoil. This car itself was $12,000 to fix. Customer pay, and when the customer pays and not insurance, I feel bad. He paid for everything, and I didn't want to sort of go after him for loss of use, but I did genuinely have to cancel a couple of customers. It cost me a few thousand dollars. It sucks, but like when a customer writes a check out of his own pocket, to me it's a little different. The first major mechanical, let's see what's here. So it's definitely not on the Aventador, it's definitely not the C8, and it's not the Porsche. It's at the dealership. It's the AMG GT. Like, who knew, right? Who would have thought? Customer called up and said, oh, it's making noise while turning and it's difficult to turn. I figured maybe the power steering pump went. And good news, I have a month, like it never works like this, right? A month worth of warranty left. And they ended up replacing the whole steering rack or something like that. Something big, whatever it is. It's a steering rack or whatever it is. But whatever it is, the dealership is now closed because there's a power outage, so now it's not going to be done in time. I lose about 10 days for that silly repair. This car has been rock solid. Everybody loves it. It's a standard Porsche convertible. You can't really go wrong. Corvette I'm going to be taking, I think, this weekend to Slipstream out in Pennsylvania. And we'll be out at Pocono on Sunday. The only thing you'll notice is that there's a floor mat in the engine bay, which I have no idea why the hell that's there. But I also have to put my dash back together. This should start, you know what? I had somebody on my Instagram, Joel Raleigh, was out here, and apparently he says, we think we got to the bottom of the starting issue. We'll find out in 1 second before we put it back together. Why not? Little drama to this whole thing. You go there. Should I bring the dash over here? Leave the dash over there? I don't know. There's this. Thanks, camera guy. That's me. I'm the camera guy. All right. You sit there and look pretty. Let's see if we drop voltage. 12.2, that's good. Yeah. Okay, so that started consistently, but it didn't address the battery voltage because it still drops from 12.2 all the way down to 9. He thought it was a starter, which I think there was a... I'll just stay here. It's easy. I'm getting old. I'm getting too old for these things. All right, come on. The mic doesn't help. It's much easier when you're on fire. All right, the starter had a bad ground. He thought that the starter was bad and it was pulling too many volts, and we replaced the starter, but still dropping pretty significantly on the voltage. So good thing is it starts, it runs. It's always ran, it just now, I guess, starting slightly more consistently, and that's good enough to race it this weekend, so I'll bring it out. Here's my table, because my wife didn't want to wait. So, dining table. Let's make our way over here. I got my whole little lineup of cars here. Sorry to be a little bit random. 360. It still hasn't been washed since the trip. NSX is good to go. Supra's clean. I got the dust off of it. Everybody keeps asking me about my Z28. Just kidding, not mine. It's one, we do storage here. And this is belongs to, her name is Nikki. She's on Instagram, Driven by Nikki. I'll put it in the description. You can go follow her. That's her car, which is cool. I don't know, hope she doesn't care about me showing it to you, but it's cool because you don't generally expect a young girl to drive a cool Bumblebee. Shivam's car survived the trip. And then you've got here the C8, which is finally getting repaired. It's, I can't get any downtime, and this is going out again this weekend. And again, the only thing you really lose here is you have a extra aerodynamic hood, because most of the time you're not noticing it, but the insurance company is taking care of it. The new hood, new hood, and then new, I want to call them latches, they're not latches, they're hinges behind there. Those are all getting replaced. This is getting repaired. That one's getting repaired. This is getting repaired. There's little scratches and everything like that. So this is gonna be good to go. And the Aventador is doing its thing. The Aventador is probably my least favorite of our rental cars, right? Like, I'll tell you it's my least favorite, and you're gonna be like, oh, that's the coolest car you have. The doors go up. That's pretty much why it's my least favorite. It's the least usable one we have. And it's big, it's bulky, makes lots of noise. I mean, it's a perfect rental car for anyone that doesn't like driving. If all you want to do is pull up and be like, whoa, because that thing has such a feeling to it. But that's a story for another day. But there's other cars that I don't have in the fleet that I usually would have in the fleet as we're starting to sort of wind down the season. And that's one that's going to go back up for sale at the end of this year. The Porsche we're going to keep. The AMG is going to go back up for sale because that deal fell through. That was really weird. Dude said he was going to buy it. We took it out of the fleet. We sent it over for a PPI because he asked for it to go for a PPI. Kept saying he was going to wire the money and just ghosted. Like, why bother scheduling a PPI? Why do any of that? It's really weird. And he's like, oh, I'll rent it again and bring it to my mechanic for a PPI. And I'm like, bring it right here to a dealership. Perfectly good. And he wasn't really feeling that. So anyway, the other thing that we did is we just finished up the Corvette Z06. It's just got to be have the bumper put together. All the parts came in. The total here, you know, just go to the body shop with me real quick. All right, almost done fixing the Corvette. Bolted on all new pieces. Everything's nicey nice. It's been a minute. Lost the entire summer on it, unfortunately, but I guess we'll see what happens with this when we're done, because we'd be going into the off season. I don't know if this car doesn't really rent in the winter, but just about there. Total damage on this was gonna be about 35, I think, or so grand. So not totaled. It really wasn't a bad repair, just a lot of parts and a lot of expense. So the total was about $35,000 on the Z06 to fix it. Liberty Mutual stepped in. They covered the claim, so that's good. It's back up and running, but I lost the entire summer on it, which is absolutely, like, it's tough on a year of years, like a year where normally I would buy more cars going into the summer, so it's not really a big deal. And like, if I lose one or two, it's just part of life. All of my like SUVs and everything like that went out for like virtually the whole summer. People kept renting them a month at a time. So I really had a very limited fleet this year of, I want to say, like 10 or 11 cars. And now you run into an issue where normally I'd have double that, but I'm not going to run out and buy all these cars. And then like coronavirus strikes again and the hot season's over and I'm stuck with all these cars that I can't get out of and I've got tremendous overhead. So all the profits that I've just gotten are getting burned looking at cars sitting there covering depreciation. So I kept it closer to the hip. When I get the Z06 back, I'll either sell it, throw it back in the rental fleet. The problem is I'll probably only be able to rent it for, say I get it back next week. I get like a month, 2 months maybe out of it. And then the thing is gonna go bye-bye in say October. October, I'll get rid of the Z06. the AMG GT, the one Range Rover I have, I'll get rid of the Bentley GTC and the Aventador, and probably even the Huracan Spider too. Then I'll buy all fresh cars coming into the spring. I'll probably have about five cars. I'll pick up one or two different ones for the winter. I'm even thinking about expanding to other markets. I'll announce that as it happens, but I'm building out a technology right now to make this business very scalable, and that's cool. And there's other things I'm working on behind the scenes. We'll get to that for another video. I just wanted to let you know the cars that have caused me pain and heartache, and the unexpected surprise of the year, which is the AMG GT, like, broke. And it's not like, oh, you turned the steering wheel too hard. It just broke. So that's the first thing. That's the reason I buy newer cars, is that they're generally pretty reliable. Honestly, most cars after 2010, the exotic car rental fleets, are pretty reliable. I mean, there's really not much that goes wrong. The one that gave me the most headache was probably the Bentley shocks. Other than that, it's not really the end of the world. But thank you for watching. Rob Ferretti, quick little update. I will see you tomorrow, because I got pulled over allegedly doing speeds that were over 100 miles an hour, and I'm going to share it with you. Thanks for watching. I'll see you then. I'll take this. Not editing that. So you guys are familiar with my other company, Adventure Drives, right? Well, we're going to be going to Scotland in October. We're going to be doing Scotch distilleries, playing golf at St. Andrews if you want to do that, walking around, seeing lakes, waterfalls, driving the North Coast. It's going to be an amazing trip. Prices start as low as $2,500 per person for the shorter trip in Scotland. If you're interested in going, check out the link in the description.